And we go back to a live picture from News Chopper 12. Matt Salemi is up there keeping an eye on the investigation that goes on in Cudahy right now. Matt?
That's right. 3700 block of East Holmes is where we're looking down right now in Cudahy. And it looks like an armored unit has just rolled onto the scene, so they continue to bring more equipment to the scene here. They're interested in a house on this block. Colleen Henry has been bringing us the information that they are interested in this house. They want to get inside. What we've seen over the course of the last half hour or so, in addition to this armored unit pulling up, they have a couple of canine units on the scene. They were going around the block, sniffing around some of the vehicles and sniffing around the perimeter of the home as well. And so we'll continue to keep an eye on this. And anytime we see anything new, we'll bring it right to you guys. Back to you.
Matt, when did you first notice all of the new focus on what is going on in Cudahy right now?
Well, it was right around the top of the 5 o'clock hour. Right around 5 o'clock, we were told that they were getting ready to serve a warrant, and then Colleen came on the air a few minutes later and gave the details around it, and we were able to get here. It's a pretty tricky area for the helicopter to be because it's right underneath the runway line of Mitchell International, so we're just literally less than a mile away from the airport and right underneath the approach of the active runway at this time. So we keep having to move away from the scene and move back in, but what we've been seeing over the last couple of minutes now is what you're seeing here is that they're bringing more and more equipment to this area, so this is definitely the next phase of their investigation. You can see they do have the armored unit now on scene, in addition to looks like a Milwaukee police vehicle there, a county sheriff's vehicle, and there is also a couple of Cudahy squads and a couple more sheriff's deputy squads, and it looks like they just pulled in with a truck and a little bit of a cargo unit on the back of the pickup truck here as well, that they're bringing more and more equipment here. Hopefully we'll be able to keep an eye on this, and we'll keep watching while you guys will check in as soon as we have anything new. Back to you.
And Matt, as we continue to talk to you, we just want to let people know who perhaps are just joining our extended coverage of 12 News and the mass shooting that happened at a Sikh temple in Oak Creek, that this was labeled by law enforcement as a domestic terrorist incident. So on the ground there, Matt, as we look at your chopper picture from News Chopper 12, we've got federal agents from the FBI and alcohol, tobacco, and firearms joining a local and perhaps state authorities there as they investigate what is an extension of the shootings that happened this morning at that Sikh temple in Oak Creek. Now has led to this investigation, a pretty broad investigation going on right now at a home in Cudahy. A couple dozen families have been evacuated from nearby homes.
And a very cautious approach to this home. Colleen Henry is at the scene and has been keeping an eye on what's going on from the ground level. Colleen.
Yeah, Kathy, you know, Terry asked me a little while ago whether or not I'd seen any of the major bomb detonating vehicles coming in. And just moments ago, the FBI pulled up, and it's an armored vehicle. It's armored assault vehicle, followed with tactical. You can see the white vans opening. You see agents inside. There about, I don't know, look to be about two dozen agents that came in various. One was the Humvee, which is the armored assault vehicle, and then you had the these trailers. And as I said, they're standing around at the moment. There doesn't seem to be any haste, I guess, or desperation in their demeanor, which, of course, is one of those things that when you've been doing this a long time always indicates sometimes the level of threat. So this may be a perfectly routine, or they may have found something. Now, they've been on this scene for probably maybe almost 2.5 hours at this point. So it's unclear now. They moved us away, so we don't know. You know, they were going in and out of this house until they moved us away. We could actually see them. And then about an hour and a half ago, they moved us out of that line of sight. So, the pictures that we have are from earlier. We can no longer get that vantage point anymore, so it's unclear to us. And as I said, Matt, doing a nice job of getting you everything he can get you in the air. But as I said, you can see, and now they've actually just pulled an ambulance is just crossing the street here as well. And I have no idea whether this is related to this at all or, well, it seems to be slowly going past. So perhaps it's parking and just on standby. So we'll let you know what's going on. We've also